The most commonly encountered soils in India are, the first one is alluvial soil. As I already stated, alluvial soil deposits are most important soil deposit, which covers about 45% of the land area in India, which extends from the states of Assam in the east and Punjab in the west. The depth of this alluvial soil extends between 5 meter to 20 meter, even beyond that. The salient feature of this alluvial deposit is it is stratified layers. Stratified layer means the deposition of soil take place layer by layer, depends upon the flood intensity. During high flood, settlement of coarse particle take place, and during medium flood, settlement of medium particle will take place, and during lower flood or perennial stage, even settlement of small particle takes place. As a result, the layer by layer deposition, that is likewise with the passage of time, these deposition take place and grown enormously. Generally, these alluvial soils are considered as most useful soil both from agricultural and construction point of view. It covers about 15 lakh square kilometer of the central part of India. Another type of soil, it is marine soil. The name marine come to soil, it is of seashore soil. Marine soils are soft in nature. River flowing from far away from seashore will carry enormous quantity of organic matters along with water, and when they reach the seas, there at the seashore, that organic matters mix with the soil. As the decay of organic matter take place, that decayed organic matter impart the black color to the soil, and we can feel, if you touch the marine soil, it is a smooth in nature. Somewhat it is even you can taste smell also. It is a different smell because of the smooth and smooth soil nature. Generally, these marine soils are not good for construction purpose, of course. Under unavoidable circumstances, we can construct the structure at the seashore by replacing marine soil whenever it is warranted for a shallow foundation. If it is a deep foundation, no problem, we can extend the foundation well below the ground surface. But these marine soils are good in fertile nature, and they are in marine soils, even crops and particularly horticultural commercial crops can be easily grown. We can see all along the coastal sites and even backwater of the coastal connected areas, there rich coconut grows, healthily grown coconut trees we can notice throughout the coastal area. Another important type of soil is it is lateritic soil. Laterite and lateritic soil. Laterite and lateritic soils, again, they are predominant in coastal areas. These soils extends over the states of Kerala, Karnataka, गोवा, महाराष्ट्र, मध्य प्रदेश, ओरिसा एंड वेस्ट बंगाल. इट कवर्स अबाउट 1 lakh स्क्वायर किलोमीटर. All along the coastal area. Formation of laterite take place by the decomposition of rocks. At the same time, after decomposition, removal of bases and silica present in soil take place, left with oxides of iron and alumina. As a result of decomposition of rock, removal of base and silica take place from the parent rock, left with oxides of iron and alumina. Presence of these oxides of iron and alumina impart red color to the soil. We can see all along the coastal Karnataka, right from Kasaragod or suddenly after this Madikeri till the Karwar, throughout that region we can find this type of soil. And even Goa, Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, all the state we find this this soil. Another characteristic feature of this laterite is after decomposition and after completion of this process, removal of base and silica, so left with the laterite, the laterites are ready for quarrying without burning the soil. We can use it as a brick, and it's called as lateritic brick. Conveniently, we use all along the coastal area, that sides wherever I stated, in all the states they use they quarry the laterite rock directly from the ground, and to the required sizes used for the construction. Advantage of use of varied and big size of lateritic block is we can minimize the use of the mortar, and also we can minimize the number of joints. When we can able to minimize number of joints, we can enhance the strength, and also we can avoid we can improve the cost, the speed of construction, and minimize the cost of construction. So laterites serves as a good construction material. During the process of quarrying the laterite, there is a generation of waste, and also to quarry the laterite we have to remove the subsoil. The subsoil together with waste will again generate the deposit, and this soil is known as lateritic soil. Generated waste after quarrying the laterite and the subsoil together will act as a lateritic soil, and though it contains enormous amount of oxides, iron and alumina, commercial crafts like coconut, aragonite, this rubber, even to some extent at plain terrain we can grow paddy also. In general, lateritic soil does not pose problem as a construction material or as a agricultural material. It can be conveniently used for both the purpose. Next it is the black cotton soil. It is the Indian name given to the expansive soil or expensive soil. It is called as expansive. When water comes in contact with this black earthen soil, it will absorb water like a blotting paper, and there is increase in volume. Hence, it is called as expansive. It is also called as expensive. If you take up construction activity in this type of soil, the cost of the foundation is very expensive. One way we have to remove the base soil and go for the alternative soil after constructing foundation, or on the alternative soil we have to construct the foundation. Sometimes if the structure is of more importance, so we have to extend the foundation to a greater depth. In both the cases, it is the cost of construction of foundation is expensive, hence the name. As per the convenience, we can use expansive or expensive. It is called as a black cotton soil. Cotton can be grown in this type of soil. Of course, we can grow any type of crop in this type of soil, but the water requirement for the growth of growing crops is very, very high. The formation of this type of soil take place from basalt and gabbro. Black earthen soils are generally considered as fine grained soils, having a particle size, varied particle size, from 80 millimeter, below 80 millimeter, even smaller than 1 millimeter. In this black earthen soil, fine particles are more predominant. Fine grained particles are more predominant, and hence this is considered as one of the fine grained soil. Again, we'll discuss what is fine grained soil and all in detail. The presence of a clay mineral Montmorillonite will enhance the swelling and shrinkage characteristics of this soil. The increase in volume of soil in the presence of water is known as swelling or heaving, and the decrease in volume of soil in the absence, means by removal of water or by evaporation of water, leads to decrease in volume, and that process is known as shrinkage. Both the increase in volume and decrease in volume of soil is highly undesirable for soil as a base material or as a construction material. Hence, it poses the problem. If it is inevitable to have structure or construction on this type of soil, based on the importance of the structure, we decide the foundation. For important structures, it is inevitable to go for a deep foundation. Deep foundation such as pile foundation or well foundation. If it is a lightly loaded structures, say for example a residential building or a single story or a two story building, then the lightly loaded structures can be constructed on the foundation called as underrimmed piles, which consisting of bulb shape structure. Like this, though it is these bulbs and the structures are surrounded by this black earthen soil, even after constructing the structure, soils are nothing to do with the movement of the structure, and because the entire load will be taken care by this the piles, we call it as this underrimmed piles. And these underrimmed piles are suitable for lightly loaded structure or simple structure if it is intended to construct in black cut soils. Next, another type of soil is the desert soil. North part of Rajasthan, covering about 5 lakh square kilometer, wind deposit is known as desert soil. It is predominant in Rajasthan. Of course, it is available in wherever we come across the seashore, there also we'll come across soil, but it is more predominant in Rajasthan area. Desert soils, generally they are considered as not suitable for construction activities because of their the shape. Generally, the desert soil shapes are round in shape because these soils are wind-blown deposit. Continuous movement of or flow of blown of wind makes the soil particles a spherical one. As we are aware that it is a smooth particles will not resist the loads. Example for that is if you put weight on the grains, any grains, it will not grains, say for example ragi, jowar, round particularly round shaped grains. Similarly, on round balls, if you place weight, it will readily slides. Likewise, these desert soils are not suitable for construction purpose. Of course, with modification nowadays we can able to use this desert soil for construction activities. That is particularly because of this shortage of construction materials. It covers about 5 lakh square kilometer, and in Rajasthan desert we can see the sand dunes of because of the wind blown deposit, sand dunes of height about 15 meter or 20 meters, like mirages. Another important type of soil is the bentonite. Bentonites are the chemically disintegrated volcanic rocks. The chemically disintegrated volcanic rocks are called as bentonite. You might be seen, it is in Indonesia yesterday or day before also it happened. It is, there is a big blow of the volcano, even above surface to a height of about 1 kilometer, 2 kilometer. That volcano blown after falling on the surface, it gets deposited, and generally these volcanoes deposit are called as chemically disintegrated soil. It's called as commercial clay. The particle size are very very microscopic, and they are generally used as a stabilizing agent. I'd like to discuss about in brief about stabilization. Stabilization, again, I think it is our hearing first time. It is the improvement of physical properties. Improving the physical properties is known as stabilization. It is applicable for both men and materials. So we can improve the physical properties of human beings. These days you might be seen, it is for improving physical properties, for outlook appearance, we use various costumes. Even we can enhance your physical appearance by means of this suitable exercises, gym, etc., etc. The same way, we can improve the physical properties of any materials. Likewise, improving the physical property of soil is known as stabilization of soil. Here, the bentonite is used as a stabilizing material, particularly in the case of pile foundation. And well foundation. So these both the foundations are deep foundations. Pile foundations means if you drive the piles are driven to a greater depth, or piles are casted at a greater depth, means pile is to be constructed up to a greater depth, means till we reach hard strata, the boreholes to be made, and after making borehole, pile to be casted. Two stages are involved here. First one is investigation stage, whether how long this strata extends, whether that hard strata extends. The general tendency is to place all the foundation on reasonably hard strata. If hard strata is not available at shallow depth, we go for a deep strata. Generally, the deep strata, up to the deep strata, we cannot excavate soil and it is expensive. Hence, we go for the alternative foundation. They are called as pile deep foundation. So, deep foundations are pile foundation and well foundation. During the construction of pile foundation, even before taking up the construction activity, first we have to investigate the soil, how long the soil strata extends. For that, we have to make borehole. Borehole made at the site of investigation should act as a borehole during making a borehole and during investigation stage. Investigation stage. So, during borehole, we have to make the borehole. After making borehole, we have to remove the drilling rod. Again, during testing stage, we have to insert the testing equipment. Again, that testing equipment is to be withdrawn. Almost four operations. During all those operations, the borehole drilled should act as a borehole. Since soil is not the concrete, there is a very tendency of caving in of the soil into the drilled borehole. To avoid caving in or falling in of the soil, the inner surface of the borehole made to be coated with a bentonite slurry. Bentonite is a fine grained particles. To make a slurry equivalent to the appearance of your dosa pad or idli pad, it requires about 1:5 ratio. 1 kg to prepare the 1 kg bentonite slurry equivalent to dosa or idli pad, at least 5 kg of water required. Means, as particle size of the soil goes on decreases, water required to lubricate soil particle and hence to make the paste goes on increases. So, because of the microscopic particle size and it requires more water, more the vertical, smaller the particle size will enhance the plasticity nature of the soil and hence it imparts the sticking property. That paste we can easily paste to the inside surface of the borehole. Then once it is pasted, it won't show the signs of caving in inside the borehole. Then our operations of investigation can be carried out. Similarly, in the case of construction of pile foundation, during pile foundation construction also, first we have to make the borehole of the required diameter up to the hard strata. After making a borehole, again you have to insert the steel cage. Then afterwards, concreting to be done. During all the process, that is a drilled hole should act as a hole. That is rarely possible, rare possibilities. So generally what we do is after working borehole, the boreholes inside surface are to be pasted by means of this bentonite slurry. This process is known as stabilization of boreholes. In other words, maintaining the integrity of the material or the hole made for the construction activity is known as the stabilization of borehole. So particle size of this bentonite and this black adden soil is so microscopic in such a way that even if you take 1 gram, generally they are considered as clay particles. If you take 1 gram of clay, if you keep on separating the particles, it is possible to spread the 1 gram of clay to the entire football ground, one besides the other. To that extent, we can find particles in a clay of equivalent to bentonite or in to black adden soil. Because of that microscopic particle size, there will be more surface area in a soil. And the more the surface area, more will be the water holding capacity, and hence it will impart plasticity nature to both black adden soil as well as for the bentonite.